Well, well, you're back again. So fast. I feel like I just saw you. Are you not happy with your service? What's going on here? Why are you back? You need to talk to the manager? What's up, guys? Squirrely here. Thanks for joining me. As always, just a real quick video update for you guys, because keys have hit 40 refined. Oh my gosh, it's the end of the world. Trading is dying. The economy is going down the drain. What is going on? We're going to talk about that. So, for me, there's two different camps people fall into. Either the one I just talked about, where this is madness and trading is dead, and oh my gosh, this is all bad signs. And then there's people in the other camp who are saying, yeah, of course they're going to hit 40 ref. This is inflation. This is normal. This is, keys will just go up and up and up. So what usually happens is keys slowly creep up. You know, this is just the inflation of TF2. You know, money, the dollar, loses about 3% a year. So if you think about, you know, like $50 nowadays, I mean, you can maybe go to the movies, get some food, you know, fill up your gas tank, maybe half your gas tank. And that's about all you can do with 50 bucks, right? You can't do a whole lot. Think about your parents or even your grandparents. 50 bucks was a lot of money, right? You could like go to the movies, go to a nice dinner, fill up your gas tank, fill up your friend's gas tank, go out all night, have fun, or, you know, feed your family for the week, whatever it was. $50 went a much longer way than you could do, than what it can do now. So that's basically inflation. Like I said, it loses about 3% a year. In TF2, our inflation is keys and refined. Keys go up, refined goes down. That's kind of how it is. Keys for a long time, or back when I was trading, I think people were buying for like 20-something ref, or 20-something cents for ref. Now it's 10 and 6, and now it's like 2 or 3, something like that. But I thought of a fun little experiment. So as far as my research, keys, I believe, were originally priced at 2.55 refined for a key on backpack.tf, so basically 2.5. Say, for example, if you filled up your entire backpack with 2,000 refined and you bought keys back 6 years ago when they first got priced, your backpack of 2,000 refined would be worth 784 keys. Wow. It's, you know, you're pushing 800 keys there. That's crazy. That's a lot of money. Say today, exact same scenario. You have 2,000 refined in your backpack. You're trading like a crazy man, collecting all those refined. Now you got to buy keys at 40 ref. Do the math real quick. What is that? That's 50 keys. 50 keys is like nothing. That's like a cheap mid-tier hat. I mean, 50 keys for 2,000 ref. Wow. Even if you know, with the bigger backpacks, you filled up 3,000 refined. You deleted everything from your backpack. All you have is refined. Now you can get 75 keys. Still not that much. So it's crazy to think that, you know, 6 years ago, 2,000 ref would give you, you know, close to 800 keys. And now, gosh, you get 50 keys. That's just unreal. So it's kind of funny to think hypothetically, if there's this time machine of someone 6 years ago was trading and they deleted all their items and they just filled their backpack with refined, and then something bad happened. They got locked out of their account, or they got grounded, or something bad happened. They went to school and now they can't get in their account, and they come back 6 years later and like, oh yeah, I have all that refined. That's worth so many keys and so much money. I need to take this and sell it and make some money for my trading. They jump in and like, oh, I have 50 keys worth of value in my backpack, and I almost had 800 from 784 to 50. Anyways, I don't know. That, to me, it's just pretty fun to think about how you could lose 700 keys of profit by just not logging into your TF2 account for 6 years. But anyways, I think keys are going to drop. You know, overall, they climb and climb. But usually during an update, especially a big update, they drop a little bit because people are putting them in the market. They're trading them. They're trying to get refined to buy new items. They're selling them on Steam Marketing. People are just more willing to sell them for lower, and it kind of creates a snowball effect because people just want to get rid of their keys and sell them to get some of the new stuff with the update. So they're probably going to drop during the update. You never know how much. They could go to 35 ref, 38 ref. Maybe they'll drop even lower. Maybe Valve will release something that makes the keys drop even lower again. You never know, but usually there's a little dip, a market adjustment during an update, and they'll start climbing back up again. So Scream Fortress, they'll probably dip, then they'll start climbing back up, and then Smith, they'll probably dip, and then start climbing back up again. But I don't know. Is this good? Is this bad? Does this even matter? Well, it depends on what camp you come from again. If you're a low-tier trader, it kind of hurts you because if you don't have access to PayPal or real-world money, it's tough because now the refine you're trading with is just worth less and less and less. On the other side, though, if you're someone who has access to real money, PayPal or whatever, it's kind of cool because now one key gets you a lot. You can go a long way with one key. So back in the day, if you used a key, you could get like two cosmetics, and that was it. Nowadays, with a key, you can get a full set of strangers, painted items. Like, you can make a whole nice loadout for just a key. So In that aspect, it's kind of cool. It really only hurts the small tier traders, which is unfortunate because small tier, low tier, casual traders made up a huge portion of the trading community for a long time. And, you know, that seems to be kind of diminishing. And then the middle class or middle of the road traders is also kind of diminishing. And then the high tier traders, I think there's just more of them in general because people have kind of collected so much stuff that is kind of squishing out everyone else. But anyways, that's a whole other topic. So I don't think this is killing TF2 trading. I don't think it's killing the market. It's just the evolution. You know, maybe it'll force people to trade differently. Now you got to get real money or find a way to get cash because your dollar is going to go a lot longer with a key than it's going to go with buying or trading with refined. So craziness, I know 40 refined seems like a lot, but we're probably going to think 40 refined is cheap, you know, in a couple months, you know, when you see that keys are 50 ref. And maybe in a year they're 70 ref. I mean, who knows? It could go out of control. Maybe Valve will release something where there's sort of a furnace, something that can eat up refined so they're not just being spammed everywhere. But maybe they'll just give us more backpack slots. That's another option. Maybe they'll just give us 5,000 backpack slots so that we can get as much refined as we want. But it's still kind of nutty to think about. A key back in the day is 2.55 refined, and now it's 40 ref and still climbing. I mean, people are actively trading and selling it for 40 refined or more if you look on there. So thank you guys for joining me as always. Get in TF2. Look for me. I will be looking for you, especially during the Scream Fortress update. I want you guys to be queuing for me and hunting me down. I'll be out there looking for you guys as well. So thanks a lot for the love and all the positive energy. Hit that like, hit that subscribe, share with your friends, go out there, do some trading, some fragging, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.